This video will orient you to the characteristics of a typical vertebra. The sample vertebra that I have right here is from the lumbar region, but I'm not going to talk about the characteristics of a lumbar vertebra. I'm going to use this vertebra to talk about characteristics of typical vertebrae, no matter what region they're from or they're located in. So if we look at the superior view, we can see that there's a body, and the body is the anterior component of the vertebra, and then the posterior elements start here and go all the way to here. These posterior elements are sometimes called the neural arch because they house the spinal cord. So this is the body, and this is the weight-bearing component of the vertebra. It's got a rim on the outside that's called the rim or ring apophysis, and it tends to be just a slightly convex rim that's around the circumference. In the center, it's slightly concave, and the cartilage end plate fits in the concavity of the vertebral body. This is a plastic representation of a vertebra, so it doesn't demonstrate those characteristics, the rim apophysis, as well as maybe a real bone would. Projecting posteriorly from the body are the pedicles. So this is a pedicle and this is a pedicle. So those are the pedicles projecting posteriorly from the body. This is the lamina here, and another lamina. The two laminae meet in the midline, and it's from there the spinous process projects. So this is the spinous process. Lamina, lamina, all of this is lamina, and then spinous process. At the point where the pedicles meet the lamina, or the pedicle meets the lamina, there are other processes that project, and we'll look at this side view. This is the superior articular process, and this is the inferior articular process. And then the same on the other side. Superior articular process, inferior articular process. So there are two superior, and two inferior. Those four articular processes are for articulation. On the articular process is an articular facet that's covered with articular cartilage. This articular facet of the superior articular process articulates with the inferior articular process of the superior vertebra. If we look at this, where there are two articulating together, we can see the inferior articular process of this vertebra articulates with the superior articular process of the inferior vertebra. That makes a synovial joint called the facet joint, or the zygote apophyseal joint. Projecting laterally are the transverse processes. So this is a transverse process, and this is the transverse process on the other side. So all together, there are two transverse processes and four articular processes, and then a spinous process. The spinous process and the two transverse processes are for muscle, ligament, and fascial attachment. The four articular processes are for articulation, to articulate with adjacent articular processes to make the facet joints. Okay, now let's look at the foramen. This is the vertebral foramen. And you notice the vertebral foramen is bounded by the body, the pedicle, lamina, lamina, and pedicle. So those are the boundaries or the borders of the vertebral foramen. And the spinal cord, the meninges, and associated blood vessels travel in the vertebral foramen. And when you stack up multiple vertebrae together, like this, all those vertebral foramina together make the vertebral canal, or the central canal, or the spinal canal, through which the spinal cord passes with its meningeal coverings and blood vessels. Now, there's an area of the lamina that's of particular interest because of its clinical condition that's associated with it, and that's called the pars, P-A-R-S, interarticularis. And it's this area that's between the two articular processes. So from this oblique view, we can see the pars interarticularis, and it's part of the lamina between the superior and inferior articular processes. Now let's look at another foramen that's formed by two articulating vertebrae. Notice this notch here. When we have two vertebrae together, as we can see here, with the disc, this is the intervertebral disc, we see the notch here, the disc, and then the other notch coming together, and that makes the intervertebral foramen. So the boundaries of the intervertebral foramen include the body, the pedicle, the inferior articular process, the facet joint, the superior articular process, pedicle, body, and disc. So this is the intervertebral foramen between these two adjacent vertebrae. What passes through that are the spinal nerves. And that concludes my presentation of the characteristics of a typical vertebra. Thank you.